Because the atmosphere would more gradually slow down, people in airplanes, assuming they could navigate the resulting storms, might have a better chance of surviving. Astronauts aboard the ISS would fare even better, but it is unlikely that anyone would be waiting for them down on the ground. Runways would just be entrances to the new planet-sized graveyard created by the no longer spinning Earth. People really, really near the poles might be okay, but only at first. Gusts of wind as fast as those near an atomic bomb detonation would blast past the surface and up into the sky, forming worldwide storms of unprecedented magnitude. The friction alone, caused by the now-stopped Earth colliding with these winds, would be enough to cause massive fires, unparalleled erosion, and damage to anything strong enough to stay put after the initial breaking. The sun would seem to freeze in the sky as days became not 24 hours long, but 365 days long. Without spinning innards, Earth's protective magnetic field would cease to exist, and we would be dosed with deadly amounts of ionizing radiation from the sun. The oceans would surge onto land in tsunamis kilometers high and wash over nearly all dry land before migrating to the poles, where gravity is stronger, no longer held to the ocean basins by the inertia Earth's spin.